Alrighty, welcome to Nycos Newsday. Sorry for the glitch in the system there at the beginning and for being a few minutes late for today's broadcast. But it's been a very eventful week. The rumors that I am a killer dungeon master may have gotten a bit of a hit today because, well, it seems that one of my players was actually taken from the game session on a gurney to a emergency center last night from the store of our sponsor, Board Game Paradise. And my mirror's always backwards. There we go. Just a second. Get my over there. There we go. Our sponsor, of course, for these episodes for the next month or so is Board Game Paradise. They are a store, an all-purpose role-play and board games, tabletop games store in Redlands, California, on State Street. They are the I can actually absolutely qualitatively say that they are the best game store in Redlands because they are the only full-service board game store in Redlands. Now on State Street, and I run a regular campaign, Nycos campaign, at Board Games Paradise, and that group operates under the self-appointed, mind you, they came up with this. They are known as the Bucket Brigade, and there are stories upon stories that associate the players in that session with buckets, pails, and such. So today's episode is going to be going over the happenings of the game and the game setting and the Dark Shards release, upcoming release, and many, many other things. So I want to thank you for joining us. I will be your host. I'm Jonathan Albin, the Games Master, and I'm now using the term the Games Master in a broader sense as well, because as many people know, I've been an aficionado and an enthusiast for games of any sort and stripe for quite a long time, actually. And making sure I'm looking at the right spot. I've got, yeah, there we go. Looking in the right spot now. I had to figure out which of my cameras is operating given time. They don't have separate lighting mechanisms, so the anyway, the story for this week, the most amazing stories are across the spectrum. So the first thing is that I just recently was able to attend an event in Los Angeles that was hosted by a friend of mine by the name of Craig Duswalt. Yeah, he's one of my mentors and guides in developing the Nycos brand and my operation as a whole. And so I got a chance to go and spend a couple of minutes with him. I'm, of course, not as many as I would have liked, but that's the way that goes. You go to those events and then you have to do the things that you do while you're there. And so, on the other hand, it was a great opportunity to get the word out about Nycos. I think I ended up liquidating about a half dozen of the books that I've written prior to the Dark Shards, which I co-wrote with Travis Hancock. And the event was very successful for us. As a matter of fact, the participants were, in the case of that event, all of them were introduced for the first time to the very concepts of gameplay as as a connective tissue, so to speak, for the human condition, and in particular to the Nycos brand and Dark Shards as a product in particular. So it was really really a useful event. You'll be seeing a lot of new names and faces coming up on the shows in the coming weeks. And if you haven't, make sure you press that like button down below. Subscribe to the channel to keep up with every episode of everything that I do going forward. And on the And also to consider looking at our Patreon account and make sure you do check out the Board Games Paradise. I will be developing in the next week or so an internal commercial for them, but it hasn't yet been developed. So until then, we'll just keep pointing at the logo, right? My finger. There we go, right there. So Nycos this week had a bunch of advancements. First of all, the day before I left for the event, thankfully it was a perfect day for it to happen, I got the galley copy from the publisher, and it looks spectacular. The table of contents is concise. The font I made a little bit larger on the recommendation of one of my players so that it's a slightly more beefy book than it was originally, but that's simply by the size of the text. I also am wanting to let the world know, and especially anybody who has any experience or awareness of the type of games that I run within the Dark Shards environment, that we are looking for artists and possibly some additional narrative authors to write snippets and bits for the sidebars and such for the book going forward. The original printing as it is right now is a concise work. Don't get me wrong. It's as tightly packed as I can, in that I put all of the players' material and the game master director information all together in one packet, so that for one price you get a fully fleshed, available, and functional roleplay game to engage in. So with the galley coming in, that means that this next week I can start my active calls to the game stores again and get them excited about possibly ordering the property. And I will be doing a basically a walkthrough, not really an unboxing per se, but perhaps I'll use it in the 10 things you need to know about Nycos. That's probably the way I will handle that. And it'll be actually 10 things you need to know about the Dark Shards setting in particular, and also a bit of a tease about where we're going in the future concerning the other releases, because one hint to let you know is that I have almost finished laying out completely the Downshift book as well. So once we're ready to go with the Kickstarter, I'll be advocating for the release of each of the others within that framework when we reach the different goals within the Kickstarter program. But that's for a later date. But I just want to let you know that the galley copy, galley copy is in my hands, and so we can start the active process. So if you are a game store owner, or somebody who knows a game store owner, or plays games yourselves, make sure that you check out our patreon.com account for information about the world setting and a bit about Dark Shards, and also make sure you follow us here, and perhaps also our Facebook account at Nycos RPG, so that you can get updates and information on the property going forward. I also want to thank our Twitch hosts. I know a lot of people have been saying they're going to abandon the platform and such because it's not generating the kind of, or that they feel that they're being less than fair with the content creators, but the reality is that the way you catapult yourself to get to other places is use what you have, and so it's the platform's been really good to me so far, and we are on our way to partnership. So if you get a chance while you're watching, please go ahead and hop into the chat, ping on it, let us know that you exist. If we're not here, make sure you go into the comment section and leave me a message so that I can shout out to you. And if you do become a Patreon supporter, we will also be calling you out on future episodes and on the end of any of our pre-recorded videos. They make it to YouTube, they'll also have a call out to all of my Patreon supporters and such on there. So if you want to see your name in lights, you actually want to have an opportunity to speak with us and become a part of this process, join the Patreon, and that also gives you access to our Discord. And I could keep going on and on, but I don't want to burn out my time on this episode just self-promotion, because of course that's only what I do all the time. All right, so Nycos Newsday this week. in the roleplay game session notes, going back now for 2 weeks since we didn't do an episode last week. I'm gonna speak first of all about the Candles Light crew. They are actually my Wednesday group. It's a private home game held in Uyghur, California, but it is a Nycos inclusive campaign story. So therefore, what happens in that world in that story applies to the world of Nycos as well. So they are currently in the realm or the area known as the Everdark, and they have discovered the lair of the Black Queen, and I imagine I'm going to be there'd be a lot of people happy about that. I'm going to have the sound effect for the shout and then cut this piece out so I can replace it with that sound effect. But the Queen, when they discovered where the Queen was, they ran into a prismatic wall, spent an entire session breaking down and eliminating the effects of the wall so they could continue forward. But this last session, as they entered the realm, they ran into the first of the beings that are under the Black Queen's control, and they were carapaced beings. They had a chitinous layer that encased their yet to be dead but dying soul spirit, and they were of course being manipulated and controlled by the Black Queen herself from wherever distance she'd set them up on autopilot, so to speak. And so they were slogging through these monstrosities, and we had a new player with us for that week, and Drath had made his last appearance for the week. So, he was late, but he was able to participate. And so, the Dragonborn priest, who is currently kind of a, I guess in literary terms, he is the agent moving back and forth between the two. So he is kind of like the focus point of storytelling in that aspect. And so by his rejoining, they gained a couple of new resources, which means they now have the healing potion mechanisms that he created in the product called material called Princeps. It's a new form of alcoholic beverage on Nycos, so I guess you'd say narcotic laced drink, or however you want to call it, but it is a medicinal, so they actually have the ability to gain some healing while on the road, even if they don't have direct access to a healer of any magical note. But they slogged through those fairly well, and a great many BPs were put out because it was a great session, lots of interaction and humor and such. And I got to do some minor lore dumps in the process. So if you're wanting to learn more about the Black Queen and the way she operates and what her association is with the Xylans, the story continues there. For the group that is actually on Mondays, which is the group that indecorously calls themselves the Bucket Brigade, and are found at the, Board Game Paradise Story event. And again, the hours for that, if you want to come and participate, is 6 p.m. until 10 p.m. Monday nights. The session was set up to engage the giants in the realm of Southern Cryopathia, where they are. But as luck would have it, of course, they wandered into something of a I wouldn't call it red herring. It's more of a just a singular encounter that they ran into a group of the Urgluck serving under the Ordnung King, currently known as, or is it, well, the current Ordnung King, who is operating under the name of Burbledot the Massive. They ran into some of his servants who were transiting a, I guess you'd call it a parcel, but it was actually a group of captured children that were being sent into the mines of the hill giants in the area to do exploratory work on their behalf. They liberated the would-be diggers, and once they had handily dispatched their captors, they returned the children to their home village, and the majority of the campaign was played out as they interacted with the town, trying to figure out whether the, you know, obviously the children being the youngsters, again, this is, of course, for those that are popping in and have never heard of this before, of course, this is a fantasy setting, and in that case, these things are singularly associated with the world of Nycos and aren't associated with our earthly realm at all, but they found that this small unit, I think it was like a dozen children that were being transited, along with a new NPC. Oh, they also did pick up a new player this week. We now have a pug sect gen who goes by the name of Arnold. And by pug sect gen, I mean he is a canine. He is a person of a canine background, canine ancestry, if you will, and who is a ranger, a wilderness tracker and hunter. So it was a nice addition to the group, since they have so few in terms of ranged attackers, which is, of course, a way of saying they have too many, or have enough. So just about everybody in the group has picked up at least one or two skills in developing combat at a ranged level, instead of just slogging along head-to-head, toe-to-toe. At any rate, they pursued this, they pursued the angle of trying to figure out why the kidnappings, why this group were moved, and as luck would have it, they discovered that there was a promise made by the king himself, which itself is kind of suspect because these are mortals, and usually the members of the Ordnung don't normally deem themselves low enough or small enough to interact with mortals. But in any case, they have determined that the king actually was liberating the children in terms of providing for their care by giving their parents a rather ridiculous sum of cash, something to the effect of 1,000,000 gold pieces each, in the name of providing training to these youths and to prepare them for operations within his own military regime structure. There weren't any internal conflicts in the town, and the game was going relatively smoothly until we got near the end of the basic time session, which was coming upon just 9 o'clock p.m. when the rumors of my TPK aspect was tarnished a bit. One of my players, a young lady, and I mean by young lady, she is 78, I believe. Playing a character by the name of Marianne, the player actually is a diabetic who has to go through the whole dialysis project, and she ended up literally bursting her little vein in the room and literally spraying. Yes, all over the tabletop for a second, and it was frightening and terrifying. There were several of our players that were discomfited by this sight, and so we suspended the game a bit early. But the store owner came, and everything was fine. Gene's fine. But they did have to call paramedics. The paramedics came and took care of the situation. But unfortunately, now it'll be comedy because, of course, Gene's fine. We'll be back next week. But they actually took a picture of her leaving the building in a gurney. So rumors of my ruthlessness as a game master will potentially be expanded considerably now that we actually had every player taken away on a gurney from a game session. That is the way of it. We are at, by the way, our viewership has increased greatly, so thank you for that. Those of you that watch the live streams, you're awesome. If you come to the YouTube channel and check that out, that's also incredibly wonderful. And for those of you who... Excuse me. As one of my idols, if you will, in this environment of video, as Nerdrotic would say, if you like what you see, make sure you smash that subscribe button. If you like this episode, make sure you click on that, and also click on the notifications bell on YouTube so that you get reminded every time that I release new episodes and such. And there'll be a lot more to come in the upcoming weeks on this show. My excitement level maybe isn't showing as much as out in this one because I'm just quite frankly swamped with all the things that I'm having to do to get the process rolling. But I do want to thank you for watching so far. And if you don't like this show, I want to thank you for the time you spent watching so far. And again, stolen from Nerdrotic. He's a great guy. Anyway, we will talk again soon. I am Jonathan Albin, your host, and this has been Nycos Newsday.